Joining me now is actor, comedian, writer on the original Roseanne and Roseanne Barr's ex-husband, Tom Arnold. Tom, thanks for being with us. Sorry it's under these circumstances. I'm wondering first, when you saw Roseanne's tweets yesterday, I'm just wondering what went through your mind. Were you surprised?
Well, I was not surprised what went down and that the show was canceled. I had a feeling this was going to happen to when I first heard it was coming back, that there was a reboot.
You thought this might happen. Why?
Yeah. When I heard about her politics, I knew she was when I read her social media in the very beginning and I saw how she was so into the conspiracy stuff with Donald Trump and so how far gone she was and the Pizzagate and Hillary's a pedophile and Obama wasn't born here and she was, you know, a birther and how crazy that was. I just knew that this would not end well.
Were you surprised then that ABC chose to bring it back? Because obviously they saw those tweets as well.
Right. I was surprised that they didn't do anything about it. In fact, I tweeted a lot because, you know, I figured someone would take her phone away or monitor that because it's dangerous, you know, when you have that much money on a show. We had the First Amendment. We also had the Second Amendment, but you don't just give someone a handgun to walk around the stage there. Hopefully you don't. You got to be careful. They risked a lot. And yeah. I tweeted a lot to watch out because I could see it coming because she, you know, has a lot of, by the way, this monkey thing is something she's tweeted before about black people. Why is it okay? It's a meme that she and thousands of her alt-right fans do. They love calling black people monkeys. It's not a one-time joke. Okay.
Yeah, she said something about Susan Rice a couple of years ago, right. Referencing.
Well, no, but there's more. Look on her tweet. They do it because we have a white trash racist president. That's a fact. Donald Trump is, and Roseanne and I both know in 30 years. That's an absolute fact. And instead of saying Donald Trump going, "Okay, everybody, hold on together," he says, "Oh my gosh, what about me?" That's insane. That he's like, well, what about people making fun of me? How about stopping?
When you were married to Roseanne, I mean, you also worked with her on the original Roseanne show.
Yeah.
Did she display any signs of, you know, racism or xenophobia or conspiracy theory kind of beliefs?
When I met Roseanne, I just worked at a meatpacking plant for 3 years in Iowa, and she was a little older and she was a feminist. I never met a feminist even. She was so much more evolved than I was. I mean, I was a meat packer and a bouncer and a young comic. And I learned so much from her about, you know, about not just being a liberal, but about that kind of thinking. You know, I grew up in Southeast Iowa, so I'd never been around different kinds of people.
So what do you think that changed her? I mean, because clearly what you're saying is the person you knew when you first met her and when you were married, obviously, you know, she's talked about mental health issues before.
Well, mental, you know,
but
yeah.
But these conspiracy theories and obviously these racist statements. I have
mental health issues myself. Roseanne obviously does. It's something that, you know, right before we got married, I went to rehab. You know, I'm an alcohol and drug in recovery for both those. She was there for me. And then after we got married, you know, we dealt with her mental health issues as a family. And she's done amazing with that. And, you know, it's something that she's dealt with. And I can see that. And the thing about, I have to say this about the president we have and his gaslighting and lying. You can see him perpetuating mental health issues for the entire country. Every day he gets on TV and lies. And he perpetuates fear and anxiety. He never says things are great. He says, oh my gosh, look how dangerous it is in the inner city and black people. And I really genuinely believe he thinks black people are dangerous and so, Mexicans are rapists. He believes that. So he perpetuated that fear to America. Watch out. Mueller's lying. He's after me. And so Americans are sitting home like Roseanne and her fans are like, oh my God, what is happening out there? And they get anxiety and they have anyone with mental health issues like Roseanne is going to heighten things. And she's having mental health issues right now. And I'm sure that's part of this. It doesn't make it okay.
Yeah, yeah.
They had to cancel the show.
You told The Hollywood Reporter today that Roseanne, in your view, may have wanted the show to be canceled.
100%.
Why do you think that is? I mean, I think you were intimating in the interview that, you know, she does something, it's successful, and she's not happy with it, or she feels she's being mistreated or something. Is that, why do you think she wanted it canceled?
Well, I feel from day one, you know, she didn't get created by credit on her own show. So what was not her fault. Obviously, she deserved it. So from day one on the Roseanne show, you know, she felt like, okay, I'm not getting, you know, so there's always been that. So I feel like, you know, that she probably, you know, as I'm watching this happen, by the way, she keeps sabotaging things. When the Parkland kids, she called one of them the Nazi, and then they had to take it down. So she throws Nazi around a lot. So I'm talking to my former stepkids, who I love, and, you know, they're suffering through this. So I look at it like, as this is going on, like, also, once you have stepkids, you always see them as kids, even though they're 40, and you know they're suffering. So you see this thing happening publicly. So I tell them, listen, first of all, I would love it if she came out and said, okay, I'm sorry, I've gotten too into this thing. Maybe I need to step back, and maybe her fans would see this. I wanted one Donald Trump supporter, one person that's all in on all this conspiracy, Hillary's a pedophile, Obama's whatever, to say, wait a minute, maybe that's not true. Maybe everything Trump says is not true, you know, the whole country to say. But anyway, so as this weekend approached, I can see it coming, I can see things going, and I tweeted at Wanda Sykes, because Wanda Sykes was like, impeach Trump, and I said, hey, it's too bad you aren't on a TV show. She's the head writer of Roseanne. Too bad you aren't on a TV show and you could do something about it. It's none of my business, but I stuck it in there. And then Roseanne put a picture of Hillary Clinton and next to a donkey with buck teeth. For some reason, she did it, and I said to Roseanne's daughter, your mom needs to have apologized to Hillary Clinton.
Well, I know you were hoping that somebody in her life would basically kind of intervene, take her off Twitter. I got to get a quick break in, Tom. If you could just stick around, I want to talk to you on the other side of this. We'll be right back. We're back now talking with Tom Arnold, Roseanne Barr's ex-husband. Appreciate you sticking around. Do you think that Roseanne has people in her orbit right now who can kind of intercede, who can maybe get her off Twitter or help her out in terms of how she should move forward from this?
I hope they're fired today. I have been there 24 years. I sense that today after something like that, that maybe the people close ranks. And, you know, I know her son did as good a job as humanly possible of taking down stuff on Twitter and trying to keep, you know, her kids are amazing kids. They do everything humanly possible, you know, and they love their mom so much. And, you know, maybe this is for the best, the family to pull together now and just be a family. And so other people, somebody could have done, there's a million things I was offering. I said, listen, you know, tell your mom that Donald Trump doesn't carry his own phone. He has a dude do it. And he thinks of the tweets, and another guy, he's so important, he has another guy type it. And then she won't carry her own phone. Mm. You know, like, or have a fake phone. There's a way to do a phone that goes into another server. I had a whole bunch of ideas.
You know, let me ask you, because one of our former guests was saying that you know, he felt that President Trump had been friends with Roseanne for decades and decades. I understand that you actually question whether President Trump was really ever a fan of hers or just wanted to take credit for her ratings. Because I know you say that one time Mr. Trump criticized her directly to you after your divorce.
Well, we filmed the HBO special at his Trump castle. I knew him better than Roseanne. He used to come on my sports show. I went to the Playboy Mansion with Donald Trump. I wasn't the creepy guy. We went to visit Karen McDougal. I knew him a little bit. Donald Trump, he's not friends with anybody. Okay, once we were at, I think it was Elton John's AIDS thing for the Oscars.
Right, the Oscar party, which we actually have a picture of him talking to you there.
Okay, this happened. He's with Melania, and I'm with my wife at the time, Shelby Roos, who's a political consultant, and he said to me, oh my gosh, you've married up in the world, and he goes, Roseanne was disgusting. And he said that to me, like, out of the blue, like, you don't want your, no matter what kind of divorce you had, like, that's a weird thing to say. That's in the moment. Like, I'm looking at him like, what?
That's what was like, happening in that picture.
That's what was happening in that moment. It's such a weird. I remember thinking, why would he, like, why offer that? Like, and he just sort of dead-eyed just offered that thing. Like, it was weird because it was a while after her divorce, and just to offer that matter of fact.
So
when you heard
the president essentially embracing her for her ratings, saying he called her up in that speech, talking about how great her ratings were, and that it was about us, or that was the term he used talking in front of this audience. Do you think that was genuine?
I think it's sad. It's like all the people that today, I'm sure, disappeared from Roseanne's life. There's all kinds of alt-right, the people that want to start a race war, civil war, they're all gone. All the people that were just worshiping her, the QAnon people yesterday, and they're gone because she has no show today. So there's that. And so, that's sad.
Yeah.
But it's also sad that she called black people monkeys, because that hurts people's feelings. And I'm tired of white people going, well, I'm going to make it's okay for us. We didn't mean it. It's ridiculous in this country that we're always justifying it. And Michael Caputo or whatever, hey, trope?
A known trope.
That's ridiculous. Shut up. It hurts people's feelings.
Yeah.
What is wrong with us?
Well, it's certainly certainly a racist comment, and not the first time she said that.
No!
Tom Arnold, I appreciate talking to you. I'm sorry it's under these circumstances.
Buddy.